Hello people, welcome here. Let's discover quickly Adobe Premiere Elements 12 and all you need to use it. Leave comments to correct mistakes in pronunciation. Check the quick index in the video description to get what you are looking for. Premiere Elements 12 is a simple software used to create great videos, slideshows and video editings. This software is outside the rental model system, so you can get it without any subscription to Creative Cloud. When you open it, a welcome window appears, showing you two options. The organizer is used to manage and collect your photos and videos. If you are interested in the organizer, watch the related video in our channel. Video editor is the heart of the software instead. Let's get a general overview. This software is composed by three different parts, listed on top. The quick and the guided modes work together. Through quick you can create the basis of your video, and, in case you need help, simply go to guided and choose the right help you need in the list. The software itself will tell you what to do in each case. What we are going to see is the expert mode. If you know this one, you can do anything with this software. Let's see the whole workspace. On the thick and gray bar above, you can add media and share your final project. On the center, you have a full preview of your project in progress. A writing will appear on if you use the trial version. You may need to purchase the product not to have this. The dark gray bar has the zoom and the player on the center. Click and drag on the time to move the playhead in your timeline. On the left you can add markers to save instance of time in your timeline. On the right you can fully rule the zoom of your timeline. You can do so holding Alt down and using your mouse wheel. Use the mouse wheel to move along your project. At the bottom you have the timeline, where you work and create your project in full. The main options and effects are all in the buttons more at the bottom that we are going to see. Let's see how to add files. You just need to drag them in the right track in the timeline. A track is each single row you see in the timeline. There are two main kinds of tracks. The video tracks, indicated through a frame icon that welcome anything visible, such as images and videos, and then there are the audio tracks, with a loudspeaker icon that have sound files and the audio of the videos. Don't mind about the other kinds of tracks you see. You can rename a track right-clicking and going to Rename. Go to Add Tracks to add new tracks, audio or video ones. Click on the white arrow to reduce or expand the track interested. When you add files to the tracks, the project assets in the top left corner shows you the list of the files used in your project. Through the icons in a corner, you can see that you can use three main kinds of files: the images, the soundtracks and the videos. You can add using the Add Media panel as well. You can check your project anytime using the preview. Click on an instant of time to set there the playhead. The preview will show you the image or the video frame where the playhead is set. You can play and stop fast pressing space from your keyboard. Let's see how to build your video project. Click on a file and drag it to move it. You can move it along the same track or in another one. Approach the edges of the file to stretch it or shorten it. For videos and audio files that have a beginning and an end, you cannot stretch over their natural duration. You may need to copy and paste multiple times to use the same file. You can cut, Copy and paste first using Ctrl and X, Ctrl and C and Ctrl and V. You can cut to delete first files. Video files are composed by a visible and a sound part that occupy different tracks and are recognized through V and A letters besides the clip name. They usually go and move in couples, but you can unlink them holding Alt down and moving one of them. The time shown on represents the time shift between video and audio than how they were originally. You can also split a clip. Select it and set the playhead where you want to split. Then just click on the scissors icon. Last thing to keep in mind is the video tracks order. A video file that is in a track upper than another one is always shown on the track lower in position. This doesn't happen with the audio files, since they can be played all together. In case you mistake while building your project, you can use the undo and redo buttons in the bottom left corner. Use the organizer button to open the organizer. Let's see all the buttons at the bottom. These contain all the features of Premiere Elements. Go to Instant Movie to create a kind of movie with effects and transitions ready to be used. The process is fully guided, and you just need to choose which photos and clips to add in. Click on the Play button to get a quick preview. Transitions is used to add them in your timeline. There are two kinds of transitions. If you have a unique clip, simply select your favorite transition and approach one of the extreme edges of the clip. An icon with a rectangle plus a diagonal indicates you that you are going to add a transition. However, this is a single-side transition that goes from blank to the clip or vice versa. You can do double-side transitions too, so transitions between two different clips. Make sure that the two clips are put one next to the other. Then simply drag the transition between the two clips to edit. Make sure to choose between clips when the small window appears. This lets you decide where the double side transition must be applied. Choose left clip to apply it on the left clip only. Right clip for the right clip only. Transitions are indicated through a big white arrow on the same bar used to show the name of the clip files. Drag there another transition to edit its kind. Right click on it to delete it. Drag its edges to set its time duration. Use titles and text to add text or credit rolls. Simply pick one and drag it onto your timeline. Since credit rolls or text are visible, they are placed in video tracks. You can fully adjust your text through the right window. Try it out. Use the preview to edit your text. Click inside to start editing and writing. Hold Ctrl down and drag to move. If you use the squares instead, you will sides. Approach them to rotate. Premiere has nice audio and images samples that can be used. Go to Audio to choose between soundtracks and audio effects you can use in your project. Click on the title to browse through the full collection. Go to Graphics instead if you are interested in sample images. You have here the Tools button as well. This contains advanced effects and tools to give a different point of view to your project. Try them when you are a little more practical with Premiere Elements. Last things we are going to see are the adjustments and effects. The first ones are used to correct and enhance your project. The second ones to add a special aspect. The adjustments are listed all in the Adjust button on the extreme right. Any adjustment chosen is applied on the selected clip at the moment, and they do change in case it is an audio clip or a visible one, of course. The eye icon shows or hides the enhancement. You can choose between the sample presets, or you can be more precise using the bars that appear when you click on More. Use Auto to set the adjustment auto. Use Reset to come back to the original settings. The active effects are indicated through a green circle on the right. The Effects button at the bottom lists all the effects the software has. Simply pick the one you prefer and put it onto the right clip. All the effects added to a clip are listed next to its name. Just click on the small black arrow. Simply choose the effect to edit, and this will appear next to the clip's name. Then pull the yellow line up or down to edit the value of the effect chosen. In this way you will edit the effect on the whole clip. To edit the effect during time, you need to use the keyframes. Open the Applied Effects window. This lists all the effects related to your clip selected. Use the eye to hide the effect, or the bin button to delete it. Use the arrow to reset the value. Click on the clock to activate the keyframes. A single keyframe sets, at an instant of time, a determined value for the effect. In this way, two keyframes with different values create a smooth change of the effect in time, from the first keyframe to the second one. A keyframe is added every time you change the value in a different instant. Simply set the right instant with the playhead and change the value. The different keyframes will be shown as gray rhombuses on the yellow envelope line of the effects property interested. The different keyframes will be shown as gray rhombuses on the yellow envelope line. Simply click again on the clock icon to delete all the keyframes. Very well, let's see how to save your work. Go to File and then to Save As, to save your project as .prel, to open and edit it in a second moment. The project will be saved with all the needed files in folders. If you want to export your video to watch it, you need to go to Publish plus Share in the top right corner. Use Computer to save your video in your hard drive. Choose then Adobe Flash Video to get .flv files. Use MPEG for .mpeg files and AVCHD for .mp4 files. Use Browse to set location and click on Advanced to set resolution and quality. Tick on Share Work Area bar only to render just the clips that are under the Work Area bar, the light gray part in the timeline. Click and drag on top to move it. Drag the edges to change its length. Then go to Save. Thanks for watching this video. Check also Adobe Photoshop Elements 12 in our channel. Bye!